Hi Rohit, a very warm welcome to you. Thank you for joining in tonight. I'm really excited about interviewing you. We've known each other for a long time, but it's a different kind of setup for us to speak. So even though I know you really well, but I would like you to introduce yourself to your to our audience. Can you just tell us something about your background, what you do, where you're from and everything, please?
Sure. Hey, Sudhi. So it's always a pleasure to talk to you. As you said, I think we have known each other for a long time and actually worked together quite a lot. So yeah, I think my introduction will not mean much to you, but yes, I think I'll just quickly summarize for everybody. I am Rohit Vaze. I belong to the IT industry. I have been working in the IT industry for almost 15 years now. Currently, I work as an agile coach with a product company. I am a computer engineer by profession, but then I jumped and did my MBA and moved away from technology, I would say. I mean,
okay.
I was a coder to start with, but then I moved away from coding and moved into more people-centric roles, I would say. And okay. That is what I love to do.
That's wonderful. And 15 years, you would have gathered a lot of experience, a lot of knowledge. But what do you think was missing in your armory, in your skill set until now?
So, I think 15 years is a long time. And if I look back at it, I mean, when I said 15 years, I was thinking, is it really 15 years? I mean, have I been working in the IT industry for almost 15 years now? And the answer is yes. I think the reality says so. But I think throughout my journey, I think what I've noticed is that you sort of work in autopilot mode, right? I mean, you just get done with your job, you switch careers, you switch your jobs, you move from one company to another, and you have a slight change in the role that you play, but you kind of
move through the paces.
You move through the paces and move up the ladder as things come along. But I think what has changed right now is, I think in the last few years, I've noticed that I've become more disciplined and more diligent.
Okay.
I think that is something that has been brought about with some conscious effort. So I think it was time where I had to wake myself out of the slumber and then basically focus on some things to improve and learn. And that is the difference that I kind of see in myself in the last few years.
Amazing. You know, but discipline that you talk of, I read a book recently. It's called Grit, it's a very well-known book. And in that she says, the author, it's a lady, she says that, you know, as we grow older, our grit or our determination and discipline increases. So maybe 15 years is what it took for you to become disciplined. Hey.
I mean, I would agree to that. I think I don't have too many gray hairs to show here, but I think I have
not
got
yet.
I've got some experience to talk about, and I think I agree that I think that grit increases. Yes. I think with time you understand, you look back at your past and you see that there have been some things that could have been better, and I think as you realize that, I think you work upon it, and that is where I said that you have to wake up from that slumber. Otherwise, you'll just carry on in your autopilot mode.
Absolutely. And, you know, apart from what you just explained regarding your discipline and, of course, grit, what is the one principle in life that you live by? What is it that is most important to you?
Do I need to just talk about one principle or can I talk about multiple principles?
Multiple. That's perfectly all. Whatever is really, really important to you.
Yeah, I think one thing that has actually helped me a lot in my career and in my life as a whole is that I think you always have to be open to new experiences. What I've found out is that if you are willing to understand the perspective of everything that comes your way, I think that is going to be the biggest learning of your life. I mean, never dismiss any experience as something that is not going to enrich you. And that is the one principle that I've lived by. I think.
Can I butt in and ask you for an example where you realized this, that not to trivialize any experience, any such experience that you would like to share?
Mm,
it seemed minor, but ended up being quite big.
Yeah, I think the biggest thing that I think I can talk about is my stays in various countries when I was on site, right? Mm-hmm. So there actually you come across a lot of different people, right? I mean, they come from culturally different backgrounds. They have different work experiences. They may not even belong to the IT industry to start with. Mm-hmm. Right? And I think that was an experience that I can never forget about. Mm-hmm. One was with when I was doing my MBA in the UK. That was a separate experience. And mm-hmm. also when I was on site with my previous company, where I think I got to meet a lot of culturally different people. And they come up with a different perspective and they look at things very differently. Right. And that is where you have to keep your mind open and take in those experiences and actually build on top of it. Right. I mean, that is where you don't dismiss them as being naive or being totally different to you, and there is nothing to look forward to in that conversation. But I think that is something that gives you a lot of points to ponder on.
Yes. So being open to experiences is what you think is one very important principle. You said there are others as well.
Yeah, sure. So I think other thing that I have kind of stuck by is that if you feel stagnant, I think that is where you have to move on. I mean, that is the conscious effort that you have to do to get out of your comfort zone and try something different. I think that feeling of stagnancy is kind of puts me in a very uncomfortable spot. I think that is where I kind of keep a lookout for things which will put me in a monotony. And I think that is where I want to kind of pull myself out of that monotony and do something different. So in the context of the career, if it means that there is nothing new left to learn in that particular job, or if you're not being able to kind of get highlighted into other different aspects of your job, and probably that is the time to move on. But just because it's your comfort zone and it's paying well, it's not a reason to kind of stick with it. I think that is where you have to keep on moving and make sure that you reach higher levels, not only in a career, but also in your life.
So what you're saying is that if you're in a comfort zone, then maybe it is time to pull yourself out of it and put yourself in an uncomfortable zone or a new place.
That uncomfortable zone will only remain uncomfortable for a certain period of time. Once you start acknowledging that this is your uncomfortable zone and you are learning from it, I think it will start becoming your comfortable zone, right? And that is when you then go through the same cycle again. You start with something new, you find it is to be difficult, and you put some effort into it, you get used to it, you start learning new stuff. Once that learning reaches a spot and you feel that there is nothing left to learn here, you move on.
Very, very well said, and it's very interesting because most people are seeking a comfort zone and intending to just be there for the rest of their lives, and that doesn't really happen, and then that disturbs them a lot. Whereas you say that one should actively seek and look out for uncomfortable zones. My follow-up question is, along those lines, what is that one situation that changed you as a person? Maybe it was an uncomfortable situation, maybe it was, exhilarating, whatever it was. What was that one situation that you can think of which made the biggest change in you as a person?
I can safely say that situation was when I actually moved out of India to do my MBA in UK. I think that was the biggest change in my life. I think till that time, I had always stayed close to my family, close to my home. I can even safely say that I think I the entire life rotated in that periphery of 5 to 10 kilometers around my home, right? And that is how far I actually had gone before that. The biggest step was, I think I had to move out of my family, travel to the UK and stay all alone by myself, right? And that was the biggest challenge. That was the
how long was
thing that?
That
I had pulled myself out of my comfort zone right away. Fend for myself, meet new people, face uncomfortable situations. I remember being nervous and even not being able to answer the questions that the air hostess was asking me when I was in the flight, right? And I was so nervous because I had never actually traveled outside the country. That was the first time I was doing so.
And what was the duration? How long was it for?
So it was 1 year. And this was like when I started with this journey, I was really very nervous. But by the time I was out of it, I had gained a lot of confidence. I think I had sort of met new people. I had gained new perspectives. I had made new friends. I mean, not only compatriots, but people from all over the world were my friends at that time. So I think that really, really changed my entire life after that. So
in 1 year, you grew like 10 years.
Absolutely. Absolutely. That is why I recommend anybody who comes to me and asks me whether they should do an MBA. I always recommend that go outside your country and do MBA, because okay. I think the real meat of that MBA lies in the fact that you interact with new people from different mm-hmm. cultures and you understand perspectives of a different culture altogether. That is what enriches your entire experience.
Wonderful. Just yesterday, my daughter was telling me that she wants to go overseas for her post-graduation. Mm-hmm. And I don't know which country and what she's going to study, but she insists that she wants to do it overseas. So MBA or otherwise, do you think she should do that? What would your advice be to me and to
Absolutely.
Her?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I mean, I think I would wholeheartedly give her the permission to go outside and study, because it's going to enrich her life a lot, I think. That experience is unparalleled.
Okay. I will share your opinion with her, and your advocacy sure. means a lot. So definitely that's very nice to know. Yeah. And, you know, we are part of the Leadership Mastery System, and you have been there right from the beginning when we started in August last year. So mm-hmm. how has the experience been for you so far in the Leadership Mastery System, having been an active member, one of the founder members, and you have been contributing a lot as well in the community. So tell us about, you know, your take about the Leadership Mastery System.
I think very kind of you to call me a founder member, Suji, but I think I won't qualify myself as a founder member. But yes, I think I have been there from right from the first day, I would say.
Yes, you have.
And I think the discipline and the diligence that I talked about earlier, I think it comes from the fact that I have been also part of this mastery system, right? And this is one of the avenues where I actually draw my energy from, right? So if it is about mm-hmm. discipline, say, for example, if you need to learn new things, mm-hmm. this is the session or this is the forum where I think I get to know new things and which leads to other things also, right? I mean, once you understand a topic, then you kind of, it encourages you to go further and talk about it or read about it, right? So this has been one of the avenues where I have kind of made sure that new things are being grasped and more things are actually coming out of those things that have been taught or discussed in these the Leadership Mastery Forum. So I think
Wonderful.
That is one of the avenues for drawing the energy. And also I think those 21 days challenges, right? I think one of the things that actually help you to inculcate good habits, I think yes. is the fact that you keep on doing them and you find more avenues to improve on yourself without anybody pushing you, right? So I think that has been, I think, very enriching. So I think that discipline and diligence comes from the fact that I have made sure that I keep on attending these sessions and also contributing, right? I mean, as you had said in one of the sessions that you will attain mastery only when you teach it, right? Otherwise,
yes, yes,
it
absolutely.
Is only superficial, right? So I think that has also helped me to kind of open up to other folks, help a lot of people in the forum, right? I think a lot of people have reached out to me for the advancement in their careers or probably also taking a look at their resumes or giving advice on some certifications. So I think it has helped me to kind of grow my network also.
So viewers, for your information, Rohit and I, we have been together for a long time. Even before this Leadership Mastery System was set up last year, Rohit and I were together in an organization. We worked together on an assignment. We spent time in South Africa together, learned a lot from one another. I definitely have learned a lot from you, Rohit. And Rohit has been an amazing contributor in the Leadership Mastery System. And like he just said, we have an amazing community. And Rohit has been there right from the inception. He always attends sessions and he has conducted sessions himself. And there are many times when I refer people to Rohit. So if there is anyone asking about Agile or Agile coaching or, you know, who wants to become a Scrum Master in an IT organization, I always refer them to Rohit. And besides that, you know, if anyone wants their CVs to be reviewed, Rohit is the go-to man. Many times when I conduct my weekly session and I want to know how it is going, did it go well, not so well, what else can I do to improve? Rohit is the first person that I always connect with. Thank you so much for that, Rohit. Rohit, you spoke about how your journey to the UK for your education and also your travels to different parts of the world has helped you develop your personality. So apart from those experiences, is there any one person or maybe multiple people that you owe your success to that have made a big influence in you in life?
Well, definitely. I think I would not attribute my success to, say, one person. I would say that there have been different people who have actually helped me throughout this journey. I mean, as we speak, I think a lot of names pop into my mind. And I can say that these people have made significant contributions in the way I am actually operating right now. Right. They have contributed with their knowledge. They have given me personal advice. They have forged that relationship with me to make sure, and they have kind of selflessly made sure that I am actually progressing as in my career as well as my life, right? So I think their contributions have been invaluable in basically making sure that I have reached the position where I am right now. So I can never undermine their contributions. And I think I keep on seeking people who will enrich my life, right? And they will kind of not unknowingly, but without saying so, they will basically take the role of a mentor, right? I think that is where you talk to them, you ask them for their opinion, they will advise you, you will have a meaningful conversation with them. And I think that is what enriches your experience, right? So I think, as I said, always be open to new experiences. I think these people bring in new experiences. So at every stage in life, I have been fortunate enough to find good people who always help me.
That's wonderful. And that is very true. At different stages, we would have different teachers, you know, the ones who would impart the right kind of lessons, the lessons that are necessary at that point in time to us. Very true, Rohit. Before we close, I'd like to ask you one last question, which is for aspiring leaders who are new into management and or maybe who are already there, they've been doing it for a little while, maybe at mid-level management. What is the one piece of advice that you'd like to give to them?
Okay. I think I would talk based on my personal experience. And I would say that the one thing that has actually benefited me a lot is being self-aware. Okay. I think we have been talking about emotional intelligence and how the first step to emotional intelligence is being self-aware, right?
Yes.
So absolutely. I think one thing that has helped me a lot is being self-aware. I think once you start being self-aware, I think that is when you will understand what things are being done consciously, what is being done unconsciously, what are the areas of improvement for you. And when you work on those areas of improvement, you will automatically see the results in real life. And it has worked miraculously. I mean, I can totally vouch for it based on my personal experience. So I think the biggest piece of advice is stop being on autopilot. Start being self-aware, and that is where you'll find the areas of improvement. That piece of advice is for the person who, I mean, for yourself, right? I mean, you basically look inwards for that.
Look
for
within, yes.
But if it comes to like being outwards and trying to find motivation from external sources, I would say that take the effort to reach out to your two people. I think they are going to be the biggest supporters. I think you will not be able to achieve success on your own. So I think look out for people, be it seniors, be it juniors. You will always find motivation, always find good things and new experiences. So I think always keep the good rapport with all the team members that you have. And I think be patient and keep learning. I think patience always helps. And I think patience also comes from being self-aware. But I think to call out separately, I think being patient is also going to do wonders. I think wait for the right opportunities and grab those opportunities. I think that is what will give you the best results in life.
Absolutely. Very well said, Rohit. And like always, it's a great experience talking to you. A wonderful learning experience as well. Thank you so much for your time.